Hello Storyboarders, my name is Eric and today I'm going to show you how to make a worksheet template using one of Storyboard that's pre-made templates. So to start, all you have to do is select one of our many categories. I'm going to go over to most popular and choose character map. Now in character maps, you can choose one of the pre-made templates, pick whichever one you like. I'm going to go with this one. Click the copy template button below. Now this will bring you directly into the Storyboard Creator where it will prompt you to give your worksheet a name. So you can name it whatever you would like, then click continue. All right, now it is time for us to customize our worksheet. This is where we get to add directions, change text, and add any images and make any other changes that we would like. So to get started, I would like to add a character. I'm going to delete this silhouette and add a new one. So I'm going to go up to the character menu, go into the classic era category, and let's add in a Roman soldier. Now I can customize my character with facial expressions, poses, as well as other physical characteristics. So let's make a very serious Roman soldier. Update colors. And then when you are done, click update pose. Now you can move your characters anywhere you would like in your worksheet, as well as resize them by dragging the corner of the image. So let's put him right in the center of the scroll. Now next is items. Now you can browse the items category as well as search for specific items related to your worksheet. So I feel like this guy needs a shield. Simply type in shield and then select one of the options that we have. Let's drag this one down. Now, just like the characters, you can move this around and resize it however you would like. Grab the corner, there we go, and put it right there. All right, great. Now, to change the background, all you have to do is simply select, and you can change the color in the right-hand menu. And if you want to change the background image completely, simply delete the pre-existing image and choose a new scene in our scenes menu. So I'm going to go over to historical, and I would like to add something that has a lot of room and space since we have a lot of text boxes on our worksheet. So let's see. All right, this will work very nice. Simply drag and drop, and then fit to screen. Now I'm gonna crop to fill so I don't change anything, and then click okay. Now, once you have your scene in place, simply send it to the back of the worksheet. Now you can also edit your scene. I would like to have this at sunset. All right, that looks good. And then you click update scene. Now, last but not least is text boxes. Now you can edit any of the pre-existing text boxes that we have in the worksheet simply by clicking on the text and putting in your own words. Now I feel like this worksheet needs a name. So let's call this Roman Soldier Map. Now you can also change the font and the size of your text simply by highlighting it and going over to the text editor box. Now let's change the font size so that fills that space nicely. All right, perfect. Now you can add additional text boxes by searching under the speech bubbles. And just like any of the other items, you can move and resize the text boxes to however you would like. Now, when you are all done with your worksheet template, simply hit the orange Save and Exit button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. And that is how you make a worksheet with Storyboard That. Thanks for watching and happy storyboarding.